Hey everybody, it's Glenn, back in this video with the WWE Elite Collection Series 34 Paige. On the packaging back, we get a full-length picture of Paige herself and some stats. She's from Norwich, England. Glenn fact, I applied to go to college in Norwich. I didn't get in. Meh, their loss. Signature moves, Paige Turner and Rampage. Seems if she wants to develop her moves set further, they'll have to scratch their brains for another pun using her name. Then pictured are the other figures comprising this series. They are John Cena, Rusev, Hulk Hogan, Bad News Barrett. Two Brits in one series. The Queen will be pleased to see two of her subjects here. She's a wrestling fan, you know. And rounding out the wave, it's Doink the Clown. Toys R Us were having a buy two, get third free, so I also scooped up Hogan and Doink from this series. And the ones I got were the last Paige and Doink on the pegs. Rusev was nowhere to be seen, but Cena, Hogan and Barrett were aplenty. So here she is at the package, Paige joining only a handful of divas in the Elite Collection. Kelly Kelly, AJ, Miss Elizabeth and Trish Stratus. Don't think I'm missing any there. So Paige debuted the night after WrestleMania last year, so she's now just marking her anniversary on the main roster. In the divas division, she immediately breathed a breath of fresh air, but seemed to run out of steam. Is it me, or did the popularity she enjoyed in NXT not quite translate into popularity on the main roster? Maybe she suffered from not getting enough mic time to get her personality across. I mean, I've not seen her on Total Divas, so maybe her personality shines more there. Ultimately, I just feel they dropped the ball with her. She has the talent, so hopefully they'll pick that ball up again. But the figure certainly captures her look well, from the paleness of the skin tone, to which in contrast to the blackness of her hair gives Paige her distinct look. History has taught me to set the bar low when it comes to the facial likeness of Mattel's diva figures. I don't know if it's because of the more feminine petite features of women or what, but they just don't seem to nail the diva likenesses in the way they do their male counterparts. But here I think Paige's likeness is up there with the male superstar figures for sure. And the face sculpt is complemented by the deco with her eye makeup, which is nice and crisp, and if you look real close, you can just make out her lip piercing. Good attention to detail there, but then they blow it by not giving her her belly button ring. But then she has the detail of her nails painted black, so it's a case of selective sight when it comes to the minutiae of detail. With buying the Elite Kelly Kelly and AJ, I felt a bit ripped off. As for me, the inclusion of a Divas belt as with Kelly Kelly and a more detailed paint deco with AJ didn't really justify paying that much more than a basic figure, but here the uniqueness of a new sculpt specific to Paige makes it more worthwhile. From the lace detail of the side of the tights to her studded punk belt, up to her top where the straps and their studs are all sculpted in relief. Likely had she been a basic figure, I'm sure all that sculpted detail would have just been transferred on in deco. Then for accessories, she comes with both the Divas Championship belt and the NXT Women's Championship belt. I've heard some say they'd have preferred Paige's jacket as an accessory over these. What do you guys think? I'm not sure. Here she is wearing the Divas Championship, which she won from AJ on her debut on Raw. I don't know if this is the same belt that came with the Elite Kelly Kelly, but here the fit is a little small. The addition of the wideness of her studded belt means it can't quite fit around her waist over it. Instead, it sits a little bit too high, more around her tummy. But that said, it's a way better fit than the NXT women's belt, which on her looks all kinds of clunky. It's more size to Andre the Giant. Now, a big peeve I have is that she comes with a clenched fist and an open palm, which seems to be the most used hands for Mattel's diva figures. But that means she's not able to hold either of the belts. Bugs me as Mattel themselves package Paige as if she is holding them. And AJ has come with two gripping hands, so it's not as if they aren't in Mattel's repertoire of parts. So it's left to AJ to hold them, except she is now retired. Let's just hope now she is out the door, the WWE heed AJ's give divas a chance tweet. I really can't blame AJ for walking out the door. As hostile as the WWE is towards Punk, it must make make the WWE a really horrible workplace for AJ. But back to Paige, and now looking at articulation, and the head rotates side to side a fair bit, and it can do that as they've sculpted the hair in the back as if it's swept over her shoulders, so that way it doesn't impede the rotation of the head as much. At the shoulder, her arms rotate and move up this much. She has a single jointed elbow and a rotation at the wrist. I wish she also had a wrist hinge as her elite male counterparts do. She has a diaphragm joint which rotates slightly and moves this far back. She has waist rotation at the hips. Her legs move out to the side this much, not very far to the front and even less to the back. She has upper leg rotation, and now this is where my biggest beef with this figure starts. When the figure was first shown at SDCC last year, she was shown with double jointed knees, but now having wrestled down the knee pads, you can see she has just single jointed knees. Rounding out Paige's articulation, she rotates at the top of her boot and has hinged ankles but no pivot. So in spite of my criticisms, the pros do outweigh the cons. So I recommend picking up Paige, and I have a feeling she won't be lingering too long on the pegs. Anyway, to keep the WWE action figure reviews coming, give this video a thumbs up, click the video on the right for my previous WWE action figure review, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.